Hey guys, great to see you today. Welcome to another refill with Pastor Mag. I'm Pastor Mag, and today I'm outside of my place, standing in front of a boring wall. I've got sick kids at home, and so I still wanted to spend a little bit of time with you today. So we're in Psalm 86, so we're going to just read Psalm 86, and as always, we're just going to break it down. Let's read. Incline your ear to the Lord and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am godly. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all the day. Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call upon you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my plea for grace. In the day of my trouble I call upon you, for you answer me. There is none like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All the nations you have made shall come and worship before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name. I give thanks to you, O Lord my God, with my whole heart, and I will glorify your name forever. For great is your steadfast love toward me. You have delivered my soul from the depths of Sheol. O God, insolent men have risen up against me. A band of ruthless men seeks my life, and they do not set you before them. But you, O Lord, are God, merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. Turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant and save the son of your maidservant. Show me a sign of your favor, that those who hate me may see and be put to shame, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. Here's the thing that I really love from this. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name. I love that. There in verse 11. You know, we live in a world that says there is no universal truth, or there is no one truth, and we don't necessarily always recognize what truth even means. Truth is this. Truth is that which corresponds to reality as God sees it. That's a mouthful, I realize. But there are so many things that do not correspond to reality. People saying that this is happening when it's not really happening. People say, well, I meant to do that. And they didn't necessarily mean to do that. They just want to get out of trouble. You and I both know it. You and I have both used that, okay? But there is truth. That which corresponds to reality as God sees it. Why as God sees it? Because God is the one who understands all things. He's the one who created all things. So when we look at how God sees things and say his way of seeing things is truth, gone are things like my truth and your truth and the truth beyond the tree over there in the corner. You see, it's all based on God because he's the one who created things. He's the one who knows things. And so we don't have to worry about a relative truth. There is one true truth, and that is which corresponds with reality as God sees it. So when the psalmist says here, teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth, it's not just some random way I think I should live. No, it's a way God thinks we should live, you and I both. Then he says, unite my heart to fear your name. Why? Because as we fear God, and yes, there's a fear aspect that God could rip us apart. He could make us disappear at any moment. True. But when we're talking about fearing God, it's like we fear electricity. You and I don't go walking around scared that electricity might get us. We're not scared that all these things might happen. We fear God like we fear electricity. We respect it. We come into its presence with not wearing metal, wearing rubber shoes and wearing protective gear and turning it off when we have to work on the electricity. We respect it. We need to respect God and respect what he is capable of and what he has every right to do. When we recognize that his truth is the only truth, when we walk in his way, and when we fear him enough to realize that he can do what he says he will do, it aligns us in the world. It helps us recognize that we are not the center of the world. We don't know everything. And in fact, it's very comforting there because we're able to live life for him. We know the boundaries. We know all the space and all the ability to run within the boundaries. And we also know that when we're outside those boundaries, we can go to him because he is a loving God. Because remember in verse 16, But you, O Lord, are our God, merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. He's got our best for us. He's looking out for us. And part of that is when we recognize that he's in charge. Thanks for joining me so much today. I hope today was helpful and encouraging. If it was, share it around. This is a great way for us to continue spending time together. And as always, we are in Custer, South Dakota at Crossroads Church. We would love to have you join us. And we meet on Sundays at 10:10, and we also stream on Sundays at 10:10 Mountain Time. If you'd like to join us on streaming, you can watch us right on YouTube for now. And as always, whether I see you in Crossroads in person, whether I see you online, or whether I see you when Christ returns, I'll see you real soon.